Hi everyone, Ian here, and behind me is a new listing of mine for a 2008 Hunter 36. This particular vessel is located in King Harbor, California. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this boat has to offer.
So this is the Glenn Henderson hull design Hunter 36. As we start the bow, you can see a really nice plum bow here. We have this really incredible stainless steel kind of cap that leads into the tow rail. Underneath this tow rail, every 8 inches, the hold-a-deck joint is through bolted. There is Kevlar reinforcement on the forward section of this. We have a double bow roller system with a Delta style anchor here, and then our furling system for our headstay. This is a double spreader mast. At the very top is 1-point wind speed. There is a radar, but that is going to be discontinued because of the new owner upgraded the GPS plotter system, which has full AIS and everything else. But radar, a new digital radar, could be installed that ties into the new chart plotter here in the cockpit. As we walk aboard, the side decks are two-toned, so really visually distinct here. We also have Genoa Trax lead back aft, stainless steel grab handles. All of the sheets and halyards are let in. This is an in-mast furling Selden rig. This is upgraded. These are H2O sails, so the mainsail has been replaced. And again, it's really just nice and convenient up here on the foredeck. Lots of space to kind of lounge. We do have the electric windlass with the up and down foot switches. And there's the Lumar winch and then the ground tackle. All right, so after that, we have nice cleats. There are three cleats on both sides, both starboard and port. Nice large windows here, overhead opening hatches. And then one thing the Hunter 36 possesses is a great cockpit. This is a huge cockpit for a 36-foot vessel. It also has the flexi-teak, faux-teak, that really just kind of sets it off. We have a forward bimini, aft bimini. Traveler is mounted on top of the stainless steel arch. And then underneath this hatch is access to the aft cabin. So when you're laying in bed in the aft cabin, this will open up. You have a nice opening port here, so you get lots of visual and air. We have additional storage on the port side. This is the propane locker here, to the starboard. Aft stern rail seats, which is really nice. And again, I love it how they integrate this with the stainless steel arch. Centrally located, this center seat will actually fold down, giving us really nice access to the water on both starboard and port side. There are additional lockers there as well, in a three-step ladder that goes into the water. Here we have an additional lazarette locker. And what I love about this boat, check this out, this is massive. Huge locker down here. He keeps his e-propulsion motor, but look at all that storage. There's emergency tiller right there. There's shelving above and below. I mean, just an amazing amount of storage space here. Here at the helm itself, we have the folding Lumar wheel. We have the Raymarine ST 6002 autopilot, ST60 wind, and then this is the new Axiom GPS display that the owner had put in. Also, we have accessibility for a VHF RAM mic, 4 cup holders, cockpit table. These leafs fold up on both sides. That's made out of starboard. Zero maintenance there. Really nice, convenient rope lockers to both starboard and port of the companionway. And then just above us is depth and speed. As we come down below the vessel, you can see that beautiful cherry interior. We have the galley off to the starboard side. Here we have a 2-burner stove and oven, microwave, double stainless steel sink, storage down here, this really nice large refrigerator, lots of space here, small freezer compartment, and then just adjacent to this is the freezer on this side. But look at this countertop space. For a 36-foot vessel, this is a pretty impressive galley, something that you'd see in most 40-foot vessels plus. What I like about it is this nice access to a full trash can here, and then additional storage under that. But yeah, lots of storage here. What's really cool too, this is a dish drying rack with a built-in drain. You also have a 12-volt fan that'll blow the dishes dry, and it's just really well thought out. Just aft of us is the master stateroom. hanging locker, shelving, kind of nightstand there. There's storage behind the headboard. You have an opening hatch here, second opening hatch, and a third that I showed you earlier in the cockpit where that opens up. But yeah, nice large bed here. Goes all the way down here. So yeah, your head is here, so you have the height, and then your feet go down below. And then there's additional storage just after that as well too. But again, the really nice fit finish of how Hunter's really done everything really stands out in this vessel. And then again, those Corian countertops, large fridge and freezer capacities, just something again that you'll find in most larger vessels. Underneath the companionway steps is a quick access to our Yanmar engine. This was just serviced. I think there's 274 hours on it. But really nice. This is shaft driven. We have our coolant reservoir here, our engine fire suppression. And again, just below this is our water pump impeller, easy access. Yeah, really impressive. And then you also have access from both sides. Directly across from this is our day head and shower. What I find to be really convenient is they've actually separated the shower from the sink vanity area. Vanity's at an angle. This will open up, so you have a medicine cabinet hidden behind that. Two overhead opening hatches, a full glass door that will close off the shower compartment. We do have a Japsco manual flush toilet. And then just after this is our, large storage area here. But great use of space standing here in the shower. You know, when the door closes, you can see pretty decent amount of room. Nice shower fixture there. And then just a little latch to keep this door into place. All right, just kind of another perspective here. We have just this kind of cute little, smoked, window here, just allowing light in to make it feel much larger than it is. And then coming back out of the shower compartment, looking forward is the large salon. So off to the port side here, above the freezer, is our full nav station, VHF RAM mic. We have our 12 volt, our 110 panels here, our JVC stereo controller, our water and holding tank monitoring gauge here. And then again, just a nice little cubby storage everywhere. Really nice materials. They're in really good condition for being a 2008. This table does drop down, turns into a lounge. As you can see, the filler cushion is right there. That'll go into place. So it really makes a comfortable lounging area and or a third berth if so desired. Overhead opening hatch, they do have the Lumar screens built onto them as well too. And again, additional storage, lots of storage underneath all of the seating as well. There is a Sharp television that's plugged here. He has a Roku, however you say that, Bluetooth Wi-Fi system to get all your streaming to this television. And then a really nice forward V berth. So again, the filler cushion is located right here. Below that is additional storage. And then you have a hanging locker storage off to this side here. This just kind of pops open and closes this off for privacy. But you know, when not in use, it just really opens this up. Lots of shelving around the bed itself. Obviously your head would be here and your feet would be way down there, and lots of room. Second shelving, storage here for this cabin. Again, overhead opening hatch with screens. So this will give us a nice perspective looking aft. Again, really roomy. They've really utilized the maximum beam right where it counts, giving you this large galley, a lot of countertop space, great for entertaining, really easy accessibility to the cockpit as well. All right, well, I hope you found this short video to be helpful and informative. If you would like more information in regards to this 2008 Hunter 36, please feel free to contact myself at any time, day or night. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel for additional video walkthroughs like this. Thank you again. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business.